Hello everyone. In the previous sessions, we have seen how to simplify Boolean expression using Carnot map. In this session, we will see what are incompletely specified functions and how to simplify such expressions. We will solve some examples also. Now, what is completely specified function? When an output value is known for all possible input combinations, then it is known as the completely specified function. For example, if you have the truth table, let us say the inputs are A, B, C, D and output is Y. If we write the truth table for these four variables, that is A, B, C, D, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, so till 1111. And if the output is available for all these combinations, then it is known as the completely specified function, because we have so many input combinations and for each of the input combination we have the output available. Therefore, it is known as the completely specified function. When an output value is not known for every combination of the input variable, then the function is said to be incompletely specified. For example, suppose you assume that these are again the input variables A, B, C, D and this is the Y column. So we have the defined output functions, let us say only till 1001. And for these input combinations, the output is not defined. Then such is known as the incompletely specified function. The min terms and max terms that are not used as the part of the output function are called as the don't cares. See, since these combinations are not used as the part of the output combinations, they are said to be don't cares. Let us solve some example, and also we will see one XS3 code truth table. This is truth table for binary to XS3 code conversion. The inputs are W, X, Y and Z. And binary number is specified from 0000 to 1111. What is XS3 code? XS3 code is nothing but if you add 3 to the binary number, this number, then you will get the XS3 code. For example, 0000, that is the first value of the binary. When you add 3 to this, then you will get the first value of the XS3 code. Similarly, for the second value, if you add 0001, 00113 to that, this is 0, this is 010, you will get the next XS3 code. Let us say for the last one, that is 1001, 0011. When you add, you will get it as this is 0, this is 0, 1, 1. That is 1, 1, 0, 0. So, when you add a 3, it is XS3. As the name itself indicates, it is a XS3. When you add a 3 to this particular number, then you will get the XS3 combination. So, this table indicates binary and this is a XS3 BCD. And these values are only from, this XS3 BCD values are only from 0 to 9. If I write the decimal number equivalent to this binary, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. And this XS3 code is available only till 9. For these combinations, for these input combinations, the XS3 output function is not defined. Therefore, these are termed as the don't cares. See, these don't cares or these output combinations can take the value either 1 or 0 depending upon the requirement. If we want 1 for the minimization, then these don't cares can be put as the value of 1. Otherwise, they can be put as the value of 0. So there, when we use the don't care, it becomes the advantage because it it plays a role in the simplification of the Boolean expression when we go for the Carnot map. Let us write the output equation for all these A, B, C, D. So it is A is equal to F of W, X, Y, Z. These are the input variables, which is equal to sigma. Sigma indicates it is a min terms. As we have discussed, min terms in the sense we need to consider ones into the output column. Sigma of this one is with respect to 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So for the output column, we have the ones for 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. These are the min terms available, whereas the don't cares. The don't care is represented by the letter D. Which are the don't cares available? So all these are the don't cares for all these output columns. So this is don't care, this is don't care and such till 15, all the don't cares, because the output of such never occurs for these particular input combinations. Therefore, since they never occur, therefore it can be considered either as 1 or it can be considered as 0. Now these don't care, sigma of D, can be written as, it is from 10 to 15. This is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So this is for A output column. Similarly for the B, we have F is equal to W, X, Y, Z, which is equal to sigma of, where output 1 is appearing? Output 1 is appearing with respect to 1, then 2, then 3, then 4 and then finally 9. Let us write that. It is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 9 plus don't cares are as it is. So it is sigma D 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Similarly, if we write for the output column C, C is equal to F of W, X, Y, Z, which is equal to sigma of, here if you see the outputs, it is for 0, then it is 3, then next is 4, next is 7 and then 8. So let us write that. It is 0, 3, 4, 7, 8 plus sigma D 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. We can write in the same manner for D also. D is equal to F of W, X, Y, Z, which is equal to sigma of 0. Check the ones in the output column and accordingly write the decimal value equivalent to that, 0 to 4, 6, 8 plus sigma D 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So these are the different min term list along with the don't care value. Remember, don't care is represented by a letter D. These are the min terms and these are the don't cares in each of the output column. Now how to simplify this expression using the Carnot map, we will see. This is K map output, K map for output A, the same thing I have written which we have obtained here, that is for with respect to A 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are the min terms and the don't cares are from 10 to 15. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, these are the min terms. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 are the don't cares. As usual, as in the first step, we have to write ones into the Carnot map. It is just a four variable K map. As we have studied, it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. This side also 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and then 1, 1. So we have MS with this side and LS with this side. And these are the decimal equivalent of each of these cells. It is the same thing which we have studied before, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Mark all these mean terms into the K-map. Already these are marked. We will just check with respect to 5, 1 is there. With respect to 6, 1 is there. Then 7, then 8 and then 9. All these mean terms are represented as a 1 in the K-map. And these are the don't cares. These don't cares are to be represented with respect to with the letter D. So first one is D, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. These don't cares can be considered either as 0 or they can be considered as 1. If we want for grouping which simplifies the Boolean expression, then these can be considered as 1s. Because they never appear for such so many input combinations. Therefore, we can consider them as either 1 or 0. Let us group these don't cares and 1s together. See here, this is 1, 1, D, D and all these are D. And now I consider all these D's as 1s and I group all 8 combinations together. This is one group. Similarly, 1, 1, D, D, these 4 I can group together and these 4. The writing of the expression is same as we have studied before. Only thing is, these don't cares are to be entered into the K-map and either they can be considered 0 or they can be considered 1s. Let us write the expression for this. So here all will cancel out. And if you see this, this is changing from 1 to 0 whereas 1 to 1, it's not changing. We get this as W. Write the expression for this. 0 to 1 it's changing, 1 to 1 it's not changing, therefore it is X. This side it is 0 to 1 changing, 1 to 1 is not changing, therefore it is Z. Similarly for this we have 0 to 1 it's changing, 1 to 1 not changing, therefore we get it as X and this side we get it as Y. Therefore, our final expression would be A is equal to W or XZ or XY. This is how we use don't cares into the K-map. Similarly, we will see for output B also. This is K-map for output B. The same expression or same minterm list I have written, which we have already derived from the truth table. B is equal to F of WX, YZ, sigma of 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, plus sigma D 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Let us enter these values, these minterms. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 9. And don't cares are from 10 to 15. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Now we have to group this. How we can group? See, these two can be grouped together. Similarly, this can be grouped with this. And this, these two, that is these two ones are present. These two ones can be grouped with these two don't cares. See here, these don't cares are considered as one because we can group these two ones along with these two don't cares. Similarly, these two ones are grouped with this one and this T. Let us write the expression. This expression would be Here it is changing from 0 to 1. Therefore, it is x, y bar, z bar. This expression is, we have to consider this and this for that. 0 to 1 is changing, 0, 0 it is x bar, and 1 to 1 is constant, 0 to 1 is changing, therefore it is z, x bar z. Similarly for this, it is, this side at least it is x bar and this side it is y. Therefore, the expression for B is equal to x bar y or x bar z or x y bar z bar. Z bar. So, this is the, our expression for the B. Similarly, we can solve for C also. The minterm list is 0, 3, 4, 7, 8 and don't care list is from 10 to 15. The same thing we will enter into the K-map. This is 0, 3, 4, 7 and 8. And don't cares are from 10 to 15. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Let us group that. See this group. 1, 1, D, 1. Here we can consider this don't care as 1 and group all these 4 ones together. Similarly, along with these two ones, these two don't cares can be considered and we can group all this. Write the expression. Here for this we get it as Y bar Z bar. For this we get it as Y, Z. So, our final expression for C would be Y bar Z bar or Y Z. Finally, the K map for output D. D is equal to F of W X Y Z is equal to sigma 0 to 4 6 8 plus sigma D 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Let us check the ones entered. This is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. And these are from 10 to 15, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. We can group. See here 1, 1, D, 1. This is 1, 4, this is one group, this can be one part, and since these all four cells are logically adjacent with these four cells, therefore we can group these two together as a single group. This group and this group. Therefore, since these are logically adjacent, we can group them together and this forms the single group. And we get the expression as D is equal to Z bar. Because here all will cancel out. And if you see this and this, this Y is changing from 0 to 1 and Z is 0. Therefore, we get the expression as D is equal to Z bar. These two can be grouped together because they are logically adjacent. And we get the minimized expression as D is equal to Z bar. Thus, don't cares can be used to simplify the Carnot map. To simplify the expression using Carnot map. So we have solved many examples like how to simplify the expression along with the don't cares. So we had taken the XS3 BCD code example and we have simplified that. And how to use the don't care into the K-map, when to consider that as the one, that also we have seen. So such functions where the output is not defined for the different combinations of the input, then such are known as the incompletely specified functions. and we can consider them as either 0 or 1 as per our requirement to simplify the expression using the KMath. Thank you.